Thank you. Please be seated. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Carly Rothschild, and I'm your senior class president. Let me begin by welcoming our distinguished guests. Please hold your applause until all have been introduced. I ask our guests to stand and to remain standing as I call their names. Dr. Dodd, our wonderful principal. The Honorable Dr. Scott Joftis, Montgomery County Public Schools Board of Education. Dr. Donna Redmond Jones, Director. Our keynote speakers, Ashley Parker and Yasmin Abudaleb. Whitman's administration team and our assistant principal that helped us across the finish line, Ms. Kristen Rudolph. Mr. Jacob East, Class of 2022 sponsor. Ms. Danielle Fuss, graduation coordinator. Our senior class officers, Sophia Arul-Pragasam and Sophie Hoffman, and our student government president, Jaden Vikram. And now it is my pleasure to introduce our first student speaker, Iman Ilyas.
To my fellow students of the class of 2022, today is supposed to be about us. But let's shift the focus of the magnifying glass for a second. Growing up in a bilingual household, a word I heard a lot was izzat, the Urdu term for respect or honor. I always thought that just meant listening to my mom and not talking back. But now, I realize what izzat truly means is reflecting on everything our elders have been through and knowing what we can take from the lessons of their experiences. So today, I'd like to pay izzat to the parents, grandparents, caregivers, teachers, and staff whose experiences allowed today to exist. Almost a year ago, along with more than a million other seniors all around the world, I cracked open my laptop and set up a Common App account in less than 5 minutes. And when I finally received the decision that changed my life forever, it took 2 clicks on an online portal to see virtual confetti flood the screen. Much different from my father's story of how he would only know it was an acceptance if he heard a thud at his window because the package was too large for the mailman to fit inside the box. I don't remember the last time I checked the mailbox. In a world where everything is so accessible and instantaneous, we can't empathize with the patience it took to make dreams a reality, to not have everything be just a click away. Let's take this morning, for example. Most of us have already taken beautiful group pictures in our caps and gowns and uploaded them to social media. If one of us had our eyes closed in that first selfie, no big deal. Because we can take as many snaps as needed to get that perfect pic. Now imagine peering through a small hole in a Kodak camera, with the only filter available being, say cheese, or then having to pay extra to get those pictures developed the same day, without any idea of what we're going to end up looking like. Today, we rarely have to take such chances and expect the unexpected. Those who came before us learned to be content with accepting a result that was less than perfect. So, why am I comparing our lives to the past on a day that's supposed to be all about looking ahead? After all, progress has transformed the way we approach everything in our lives. And there is no doubt that when we step off this field today, progress will continue to take our world by storm. And soon, it will be our turn to invent and innovate. But in that cycle of constantly moving forward, let's not also lose the virtues of the past, which allowed us to get to this point in the first place. Let's not lose out on learning lessons from a world of free nights and weekends, dial-up internet, and memorizing phone numbers. Thank you to our parents, teachers, and all those who have stood by us, so we too can become just as patient and resilient as you. Class of 2022, and the class of every year before this year, we did it together. This is our day. Thank you.
Good morning, friends, family, and fellow graduates. My name is Sophia Rolpergossum, and I am one of your Class of 2022 officers. It is my pleasure to introduce our next speakers, Amanda Sartori and Skylar Chasen.
What a seamless, easy, and frankly, uneventful 4 years we've had. I mean, 4 years of everything being normal and the same, day in, day out, all the same. Wouldn't that have been nice? Let's see. Freshman year, we were thrilled to have 46-minute periods. We suffered through ninth grade bio, we were still flipping our water bottles, and mercifully, we had no clue what Zoom was.
For me, it all started on this very field, running around, trying out for field hockey. I was hoping to find a community that would provide me stability in what I'd always been told would be the rockiest transition of my teenage years. Ironically, after a failed tryout or two, I found my community, but not on the field, up in the stands, cheering on the field hockey team. It's easy to be upset when the things that you try don't just work out. And while my time in some clubs may have been fleeting, the connections that I've made in them have been just the opposite. In fact, after 4 more years at Whitman, a few more failed tryouts, and some other explorations gone wrong, I found my place, giving standing ovations to the musicals in the auditorium, in the gym, cheering on the basketball team, and highlighting the unique talents of our student body in the black and white. Especially in a year as unique and unprecedented as our class's sophomore and junior year, focusing on maintaining these connections through the turmoil was more important than ever.
It would be easy to focus on what we lost during those years, but there were positives. I mean, we had junior year, arguably the hardest year of high school, online, and we added the phrase test optional to our vernacular. We learned together despite being miles apart. We saw our teachers, how dedicated our teachers are as they formed engaging lessons that made us more than a bunch of boxes on a screen. We faced unprecedented mental health challenges that led administrators, teachers, and students to come together to strengthen the support systems within our community. We saw firsthand how our school responded to acts of injustice by forming the LASJ program, making Whitman a place where students are empowered to affect positive change. And we had what maybe every other graduating class at Whitman had, but took for granted, the feeling of being part of a community.
One memory for me that demonstrates the community within our grade beyond sports teams and where you sit at lunch is a night back in December. Maybe 15 early decision college acceptances had come out within the past few weeks. Some people were overjoyed, some were anxious, and some were downright crushed. Somehow, over 60 Whitman students from all different friend groups found themselves sitting in the Whitman parking lot on a Friday night in a circle, playing Rosebud Thorn. The classic game of saying the best thing from your week, the worst thing, and something you're looking forward to. Everyone felt like they'd known each other forever. The air was filled with that same excitement for the rest of senior year, support for one another's successes, as well as nothing but words of encouragement for those who had not yet received the college news that they wanted. I looked around and realized that no matter the pressure we experience walking through these halls every day, the amount of support that we have for one another here is unique. And that's what's led us to sit here right now and will continue to help us wherever we go next.
We will all forever remember that first home football game and that raging school spirit we hadn't experienced together in years. We got to cheer on our girls' soccer team as they earned the title of state champions. We enjoyed the new luxuries of the Commons, more commonly known as the WAD. We saw immeasurable talent on display at Talent Show. We got Starbucks Hall, wait, study hall.
Recess.
Oh, I don't know, we spent a lot of time at Westbard this year. We proudly watched our Palms teams play second in Division One, and we got the field renovated.
That was freshman year.
No, that was senior year. Anyways, as we move on to our next adventures, our time at Whitman becomes a wonderful collection of memories that will have shaped our lives forever for the better. Not just because of the strong and unique people we have all become, but for all that we have overcome together.
This time next year, we'll all be living separate lives, unlike anything that we've experienced to this point. Many of you, I'm sure, are delighted, mournful, and nearly every emotion in between. Whether this was the best 4 years of your lives, you're itching to get to the next, or both, just keep with you the notion that connection will guide passion, and searching for passion will guide connection.
Well, it's been a wild ride. We will all forever be bound together by our boring,
basic,
and totally uneventful 4 years at Whitman.
This graduating class has taught me that wherever we are, we can make it our community.
And from the bottom of our hearts, we want to thank the Walt Whitman class of 2022 for being our first.
Good morning. My name is Sophie Hoffman, one of your senior class officers. It is my pleasure to introduce our final student speaker, Felix Leonhardt.
Good morning, Whitman. By now, many members of the class of 2022 are probably used to me leading us in Whitman's call and response fight song, which is our rallying cry adapted from an old camp song called Everywhere We Go. I have shouted myself hoarse at the girls' soccer state championship, at the foot of the Lincoln Memorial on homecoming, and at basketball games, to name just a few examples. I love this song because it hypes us up, but I also think that it represents the journey that the class of 2022 has taken through high school. The first part of the song goes, "Everywhere we go, people want to know who we are and where we come from. So we tell them we are the Vikings, the mighty, mighty Vikings." Why are we the mighty, mighty Vikings? I believe at our core, Whitman students are mighty because we are curious. At other schools, caring about learning may be looked down upon, but at Whitman, it is cool. Teachers like Mr. Brunel, Madam Beach, and Ms. Borsum, who encourage us to teach our classmates what we know, create an environment in which learning is fun and collaborative. I often learn the best ways to approach schoolwork from my classmates. We are the mighty, mighty Vikings because each of us wants to know more everywhere we go. Now, everything that I just said about that first chunk of the song is true of every Whitman class, but I believe that our fight song has special meaning to the class of 2022, thanks to the last part. The end of the song goes, "And if they can't hear us, we shout a little louder." The class of 2022 went through long periods where we couldn't be heard. With our junior year online, we lost the interactions that make school so meaningful. Running into friends in the hall, thanking teachers in person, laughing at lunch. However, each time we sing our fight song, we do so multiple times. There's a reason for that. We shout just a little louder the second time, so that those who couldn't hear us originally now know that we're the mighty, mighty Vikings. And we kept on singing despite the pandemic. We put on trivia nights, debate tournaments, and the talent show online. We organized rec baseball leagues. We gathered together in the Whitman parking lot, 6 feet apart and masked. We will never forget those experiences. And then when COVID abated, we returned at full volume. County and state championships, plays and musicals, prom. No Whitman class ever cherished senior year in the way that we did. We knew what it felt like to have high school taken from us and then given right back, and we weren't going to lose another minute. The class of 2022 had to shout just a little louder, and we did. This is a mindset that we cannot afford to lose when we graduate Whitman. Our generation faces an array of challenges that require persistence. Our climate is changing. We can limit warming, but to do so, we must fight for sustainable energy. Our democracy is on life support. We can resurrect it, but only by committing ourselves to voting in every single election. Disease and war have made a comeback after decades of decline, challenges that we can confront only by working with other countries instead of putting America first. Our generation has a chance to combat warming, pandemics, racism, war, and authoritarianism, but only if we continue to shout just a little louder when we can't be heard, everywhere we go. So, I think you might have known that I would end with this. The class of 2022 deserves one final fight song, as a celebration of what we have overcome, but also as a reminder of the work that we still have left to do. Remember, the song is a call and response. I'll say a line, all you guys need to do is repeat after me, and everyone should feel free to join in. I am terrible at singing, by the way, but it's fine. Everywhere we go, people wanna know, who we are, and where we come from. So we tell them, we are the Vikings, the mighty Vikings, and if they can't hear us, we shout a little louder. And if they can't hear us, we shout a little louder. Thank you, Vikes. Congrats.
At this time, please enjoy an Irish blessing performed by the Whitman Combined Courses under the direction of Michelle Kim.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Jaden Vikram. I'm Whitman's SGA president, and it is my honor to introduce our keynote speakers. Ashley Parker is the White House Bureau Chief for the Washington Post. She was part of the Washington Post team that won the Pulitzer Prize for National Reporting in 2018 for their coverage of Russian interference in the 2016 presidential election. And this year, she was part of the Washington Post team that won another Pulitzer Prize for public service, for their coverage of the causes, costs, and aftermath of the January 6th attack on the U.S. Capitol. Ms. Parker joined the Post in 2017 after 11 years at the New York Times, where she covered the 2012 and 2016 presidential campaigns and Congress, among other things. She graduated from Walt Whitman High School in 2001 and the University of Pennsylvania in 2005 with a degree in English and Communications.
A 2010 Whitman graduate, Yasmin Aboudaleb, is a national reporter for the Washington Post focused on health policy. She has covered both the Trump and Biden administration responses to COVID-19 and was the co-author of the New York Times number one bestseller, Nightmare Scenario, Inside the Trump Administration's Response to the Pandemic That Changed History. She was one of the lead reporters on a 2020 series that documented Trump's missteps in handling the coronavirus and broke several stories related to the administration's response. She joined the Post in 2019 after more than 5 years at Reuters, where she covered the fight to repeal Obamacare at the intersection of politics and healthcare. Ms. Aboudaleb graduated from the University of Maryland, College Park, in 2014, where she served as editor-in-chief of the student newspaper, The Diamondback.
Please join us in welcoming our keynote speakers.
Principal Dodd, teachers, relieved parents, proud grandparents, ANSI siblings, Whitman class of 2022, congratulations. We know it's been a long, winding road for you to get here, and you're all probably eager to debrief on Beach Week,
or stop that picture from going viral from Beach Week,
or at the very least, recover from Beach Week. So we'll do our best to be brief.
But we want you to know how special it is for both of us to be here delivering your commencement address. Ashley and I first met a little over 2 years ago when we were paired together on what would become the first of many, many stories about how then-President Trump was managing COVID.
As an editor anxiously asked on a Wednesday night, might I add, so, do you think you can deliver that story by the weekend? Yasmin and I decided it was the perfect time to discuss our childhoods rather than make phone calls. We discovered we both grew up in Bethesda and went to Whitman. And so, instead of writing or reporting, we exchanged tales of the Whitman journalism class we both took and the stories for the black and white we both filed. And I'll be honest, neither of our high school journalism careers were particularly illustrative.
But that was probably for the best. You'd be hard-pressed to find a more competitive environment than this one, or a place where you're lucky enough to work and learn alongside people who are clearly smarter or more talented than you. And so we learned to be humble, because there was always someone who was more creative, or more athletic, or effortlessly cooler, or some annoying combination of all those things.
Which, believe it or not, is one of the gifts of this wonderful, sprawling, at times maddening place. Just by graduating as a member of the Walt Whitman class of 2022, you already have many of the skills you need to navigate the next chapters of your lives, whether that's college, a gap year, public or military service, or another adventure.
If we spoke with each one of you, we'd probably find some shared experiences in our time at Whitman, even though we graduated a decade or two apart. But the Whitman you experienced has been far different and more challenging than anything Ashley or I could have fathomed.
If you had asked me, in high school, the three most devastating things that had ever happened to me, I would have told you, totally and 100% earnestly, that they were, in no particular order, getting cut from the lacrosse team, getting deferred then rejected from Yale, and not getting asked to prom by Dan MacArthur. Yasmin, meanwhile, has a very dramatic tale of getting a C in AP English.
But you had just 1 year as normal high schoolers before the world turned upside down. On top of the normal stresses of high school, of which there are many, you all navigated a global pandemic and the stress, anxiety, and unpredictability that have come with that.
You learned how to manage remote school, canceled sports seasons and plays and musicals, and time away from your friends and classmates. You learned, hopefully, that Facebook and Instagram and TikTok and Snapchat are not real life, and you navigated this rabbit hole of social media amid at what times must have felt like crushing isolation. You watched and participated as the country faced a long overdue racial reckoning, and you made sure Whitman learned from those lessons too. You worked to make sure that students who have not always felt welcome or safe here finally had a home at this school that means so many different things to so many different people. And you leave armed with the knowledge of all the work you have done and all the work there is still left to do.
Then there are the actual classes and APs you all took. AP Chemistry still stands as one of the hardest classes I've ever taken, and I took Organic Chemistry 1 and 2 in college, and I'm truly not sure whether I would pass it if I retook it today. For Ashley, it's BC Calculus that still haunts her dreams. You will be shocked at just how well Whitman has prepared you for college and life outside of school. Which brings us to the actual gist of our speech. We didn't really know what to expect after graduating high school. I went to the University of Maryland hoping to become a doctor, but I loved my experience on the black and white, which I had initially signed up for on a whim because one of my friends was taking the class, and I wanted to keep writing, so I tried out for the college newspaper. I had no idea what I was signing up for. Editing nights that ended at 3 a.m., skipping class to chase down stories, but I'm so glad I didn't know. I would have never discovered my love of journalism otherwise.
So our first piece of advice is, be open to anything. If you don't know what you want to do, that's totally fine and normal. So try a little bit of everything until you figure out what excites you. And it's totally okay if that takes longer than you think or hope it will. And it's also okay if what ultimately excites and inspires you is not what excites and inspires your parents, or is not exactly what your older brother did, or is not the most linear path. Make sure to give yourself space to pursue other interests, even if it's just some class you take because a friend is in it, but obviously don't just take classes because your friends are in them.
As journalists, our most adrenaline-filled days are often someone else's worst day. The sorts of things that make the front page of the paper or get all the clicks on Twitter, we would say TikTok, but neither of us is cool enough to be on there, are also the tragedies, the most trying and difficult moments in someone else's life. A mass shooting, a global pandemic, a hate crime, an insurrection on the US Capitol.
The stories that have sometimes led to our biggest accomplishments journalistically have often meant something devastating for someone else or for the country. So our second piece of advice is, try to go into every situation with a modicum of compassion. It is worth remembering that everyone, literally everyone, is struggling and is just as bored or frustrated or terrified or anxious or depressed or annoyed as you are. This world we've all grown up in can be a bubble, and it's important to remember that you never really know what someone else is dealing with. In short, be empathetic and try as much as possible to be a basically decent human being.
And finally, at a place like Whitman, it can simultaneously feel hard to stand out or fit in, or even know which one is preferable. When I was a student here, I did well enough, but I certainly wasn't at the top of my class, even though I felt like I studied and worked just as hard as many of my classmates who were. In fact, I felt like I often studied more, only to perform worse than they did on an exam or class assignment. My parents promised me, over and over, that one day I would be rewarded for developing such a strong work ethic, that working hard was going to be more important for my long-term success than any individual exam, class, or even semester. At the time, I thought they were full of it and just didn't have better advice for me.
And when I was here, I remember thinking that my life would end, literally end, Rumpelstiltskin style, in a puff of smoke if I didn't make the basketball team. And so every night, all summer long, my mom would trail me in our car as I ran timed miles through our neighborhood. This is largely because she was somewhat overprotective. But also because I knew I couldn't control how tall I was, not tall enough, or who I'd be paired up against during tryouts. But I could at least improve how fast I was. For those curious, I made the team and was perfectly average. Don't worry, we're coming to a point here.
What we both learned is that being a hard worker can compensate for any number of deficiencies. We're both good enough writers and pretty solid reporters. Thanks, Whitman training. But so are hundreds of journalists in Washington, New York, and all over the country. The difference is that we've been willing to do the grunt work, to get a call at midnight and hop on a flight at 6 a.m., to call dozens upon dozens of government officials until, finally, one didn't hang up on us.
And we've said yes to assignments and jobs for which we felt wholly unequipped and unqualified, like, for instance, agreeing to deliver the commencement address at our high school alma mater with all of these impressive speakers. But we had the confidence to accept because we knew we could work hard enough until we figured it out. And just one final bit of insight from your elders, if you'll bear with us. Last year, horrifyingly, I helped organize my 20th high school reunion. And I was reminded that at our 10-year reunion, two classmates hooked up and are now married with three kids. And at our 15-year reunion, two different classmates hooked up and are now married with two kids. And so last year, at the reunion, I asked one of the guys, did you ever think back at Whitman you'd have ended up with Lindsay? Lindsay, he said, no way. She was a brainiac and an athlete, and I was just the class clown. So look around. Your future partner might be sitting here today. And if that's the sort of thing you want, and it's okay if it's not, but if that's the sort of thing you want, kids, a partner, a house in Bethesda, be sure to attend those reunions.
But the truth is, you don't really need any advice, because you've already had to implement all of this advice in your lives these last couple of years, whether you wanted to or not. You've endured real hardship, had your high school experience upended, and yet, here you all are today. You're more prepared for whatever it is that is waiting for you out there than Ashley or I ever were. But if you can bear to humor us and take just a Cliff Notes blurb away from this speech, it is, be open, be a generally decent and compassionate human, and work harder than everyone else.
And with that, we cannot wait for the day when we both get to write about all the incredible things you guys are doing on the front page of the Washington Post. Be sure to subscribe. And congratulations, Whitman Class of 2022.
Good morning. I'm Danielle Fuss, our graduation coordinator. Please rise as we hear from our orchestra for performance of America the Beautiful. Thank you.
Welcome, parents, family members, staff, distinguished guests, and of course, the class of 2022, to Walt Whitman High School's commencement ceremony. Thanks very much again to our keynote speakers and Whitman alums, Ashley Parker and Yasmin Abutaleb, for their inspiring remarks. Let's hear it for our keynotes again. Thank you. Welcome back. Welcome home. Graduating seniors, today is indeed one of the most memorable days you'll experience in your lives. My hope is that you can truly be in the moment during our time together today, feeling deep satisfaction for yourselves and for each other. It's your well-deserved turn to soak up all the love and pride that our audience and special guests feel for you today. Joining us to celebrate your graduation are some very special guests. They've been announced, but I will recognize them again. They include Board of Education member and Walt Whitman High School parent, Dr. Scott Joftis. We're also joined by Dr. Redmond Jones, my amazing boss, the Director of Learning, Achievement, and Administration. Let's hear it for them. Thank you. At the graduation of the class of 2021, I recognize the long-standing contributions of Board of Education member Pat O'Neill to the Walt Whitman cluster and MCPS as a whole. Last June, she sat next to me on this stage. Ms. O'Neill passed away suddenly in September, right before I was scheduled to give her a tour of the beautiful addition to our venerable school. On behalf of our entire community, I want to take this moment to remember Ms. O'Neill for her decades of service to the families and staff of the Montgomery County Public Schools. There was no greater champion of public education than Ms. O'Neill and her impact on the schools in our Whitman cluster and in MCPS will live on. I'd also like to introduce our Walt Whitman High School administrative team and my dear friends who are on the stage with us today, Mrs. Christy McAleese, grade 11 administrator, Mr. Greg Miller, grade 10 administrator, and Ms. Alicia Marie Johnson, grade 9 administrator, our student staff, community, and of course me, are fortunate to have such exceptional educational leaders at the helm of our school. Let's hear it for our administrative team. Before most of our seniors arrived at Whitman, they spent many years in our amazing feeder schools. In our tent over there, representing our 5 cluster elementary schools and Pyle Middle School, are their esteemed principals. Please join me in showing our deep gratitude for this outstanding group of school leaders, Ms. Karen Carrasio from Bradley Hills, Mr. Jay Lee from Carter Rock, Mrs. Marita Sherburn from Woodacres, Dr. Kimberly Thompson from Burning Tree, Ms. Catherine Bradley from Bannockburn, and of course, Mr. Chris Nardi from Pyle Middle School. Let's hear it for our principals. At the conclusion of this school year, Jay Lee, principal of Carter Rock, will be leaving our cluster for a new leadership opportunity. Jay, I want to take this opportunity to thank you for being such an exceptional principal for the Carter Rock community. We're going to miss you. Let's hear it for Mr. Lee. And finally, I've known Marita Sherburn since we were both teachers in the 1990s. In the summer of 2003, we ran an elementary summer school program together at Rolling Terrace. Or should I say, Marita ran it, and I just did what she told me to do. Mrs. Sherburn has devoted half of her career to the students and family of Woodacres. She's been a rock in our community and has touched the lives of innumerable students. Marita, on behalf of the Whitman Cluster, thank you for being such an incredible principal. Your legacy will live on. Graduation also means that it's time to recognize and celebrate Walt Whitman staff who are retiring. I'd like to recognize our retirees in the class of 2022. Let's hear it for Ms. Bonnie Butler, math teacher, Ms. Wendy Egan, social studies teacher, Ms. Orion Heisen, English composition assistant, Mr. Wayne Jacobson, social studies teacher, Ms. Singhun Lin, Food Services Team, Mr. Kevin Pope, Engineering Teacher, and Mr. Robert T. Ketch, Special Education Paraeducator. Audience, guests, let's hear it for our retirees. Thank you so much for all you've done for Whitman. I'd like to thank Ms. Kristen Cody, Rudolph Cody, she needs to make a decision about the last name, senior class administrator, who did so much to ensure that we were able to experience this wonderful event together today. I'd also like to offer a special thanks to Ms. Danielle Fuss, one of our senior class sponsors and the person most responsible for us being here at graduation and the senior prom. Thank you for your leadership, Ms. Fuss. And last but not least, thanks to Mr. Jacob East, our other senior class sponsor, for planning many of the memorable events that define the senior experience. Thank you, Mr. East. Finally, one of the defining characteristics of our wonderful school is the exceptional staff sitting in front of me who gives so much to our students. Walt Whitman High School faculty, please stand. Graduates, families, community members, please join me in give faculty stand. Let's hear it for our Whitman staff. Thank you all for everything you do. Be seated. All right, now it's my chance to speak to the class of 2022, which I've been looking forward to. On August 30th, 2021, our school community set sail on an uncertain voyage as we returned to school. Although we knew our destination and our purpose, we were far less confident about our bearings and strength after two unimaginable years. The winds became increasingly rough as we navigated the impact of each COVID variant, and in January, we were all worried about health and safety and whether our school would remain open. Beyond comprehension, we felt like we were being tossed and driven by circumstances and elements that we could not control. Like any unstable vessel, we needed an anchor to steady us, keep us from drifting off course, or worse yet, slipping under the waves. But fortunately for our school, we've had an anchor all along. Walt Whitman class of 2022, you've been our anchor. Despite all that you've had to experience, you returned for your fourth and final year of high school with unwavering optimism, poise that has revitalized our hallways, classrooms, programs, and events. Without even realizing it, you buoyed our entire school community and preserved our spirit and fortitude during a global crisis. This will be part of your legacy as the class of 2022, and I think a defining moment for your generation. Another generation of young people defined an era and changed the course of history when they bravely led the Allied invasion of Europe on this day in 1944. I've heard it said that the greatest generation, that all gave some, and some gave all. We don't know yet what you will be called to give in the future, but what we do know is that you've already shown us that you're ready for whatever lies ahead. In the midst of a pandemic, international conflicts, and the ongoing fight for equality, justice, and safety from senseless violence in our nation, students in the class of 2022 took action in the face of overwhelming social crises. Whether it was participating in protests during the summer of 2020 or speaking out forcefully on criminal justice reform, body positivity, and climate change, students in this class began to chart a new course for our community and nation when the present was bleak. Members of the class of 2022 and groups like our Minority Scholars Program, Black Student Union, the Whitman Pride Alliance, SGA, and the Leadership Academy for Social Justice contributed greatly to the development of One Whitman and the establishment of our Race, Equity, and Wellness Coalition. At this point in the ceremony, I want to recognize a group of seniors who who have been instrumental in our mission to become champions against racism and bias in our community. Would the following students please stand? Leo Levine, Austin Boyjana, Christina Lemansky, Felipe DeBoye, and Tara Davuti. These seniors, let's hear it for them. They're a little stunned. They didn't know they were going to get called. These seniors served diligently on the One Whitman Planning Committee, where they have developed powerful lessons on the systemic discrimination and bias experienced by Black, Latino, Asian, and LGBTQ+ communities. Today, you five, I'd like to thank you for all the time and energy that you've given to the anti-racism and anti-bias movement at Whitman. We know that it has not been easy nor popular to be the leader for this cause, but pursuing true change and interrupting the status quo will always be difficult. Walt Whitman High School community, please join me one more time in applauding these students for their commitment to social justice. You can be seated. Thank you. Class of 2022, today we're going to recognize you for all that you've accomplished over the years, knowing full well that what you've been through recently will set you apart and uniquely prepare you for an ever-changing future. You are the Walt Whitman Class of 2022. Today is our chance to recognize your steadfastness and say thank you one final time. As has been the tradition passed down through Walt Whitman High School principals, I'm going to take a few moments to recognize the achievements of the Class of 2022. It's fitting that we're gathered today under this beautiful blue sky in the Dr. Jerome Marcos Stadium, for he's the principal who started this time-honored tradition for Whitman graduates. Therefore, when I mention certain activities or distinctions, please stand if they apply to you in any year that you attended Whitman. Here we go. Let's start with Walt Whitman High School Athletics. Would all athletes who earn state, regional, county, or national titles while attending Whitman please stand? Now, if you played a varsity sport while attending Whitman, please stand. As you know, you were rarely alone in your efforts because of our student fans who were there to cheer you on. Now, every student who took the time to cheer on a friend or team, please stand if you came to an athletic event. Probably most of you. I want to thank each of you for making our athletics program so strong. Please be seated. Beyond sports, our choral and instrumental music groups continue to earn superior scores in local, state, and national competitions over your years at Whitman. Seniors in those groups, if you participated at any point in the last 4 years in band or orchestra, please stand and remain standing. And who can forget the outstanding artistic talent we have at Whitman? Students who have participated in the Festival of the Arts, International Night, Shakespeare Night, Talent Show, Coffee House, Battle of the Bands, and the competition for Whitman Idol, please stand. And our student publications continue to earn awards while they inform and move us. Students who have been members of the Black and White Yearbook, Eidolon, Psych Journal, and Whitman Shorts, please stand. Despite the pandemic, academic teams and clubs continue to earn top honors in local and national competitions. All seniors who have been members of Speech and Debate, It's Academic, Model UN, Robotics, and DECA, please stand. Let's give this group a round of applause. Thank you, seniors. You may be seated. Whitman students are committed to helping each other, improving our world, and standing up for essential human rights. We also have students who have decided to join the military or attend a military academy. Will those students please stand and remain standing? Thank you for your future service to our nation. You may be seated. Will SGA class leaders please stand? Also, please stand if you have participated in the following: the Minority Scholars Program, the Black Student Union, or the Whitman Pride Alliance. Will all students in Best Buddies and all the seniors who have supported our students with special needs please stand? Let's hear it for this group of students. Thank you so much for your service. This year, 77 seniors earned the Maryland State Seal of Biliteracy by demonstrating proficiency in one or more languages other than English. Will these students please stand and remain standing? And 180 of our seniors maintained at least a 3.8 average or above. Will those 180 seniors please stand? Let's hear it for this group. All right, this is where it gets a little tricky. Please be seated unless you are one of the 60 students who earned straight A's throughout your high school career. Let's hear it for these 60. Congratulations, you can take your seats. Your collective hard work, class of 2022, and dedication, as our keynote speakers referenced, have earned your class almost $15 million in scholarships. Congratulations. Finally, all of our seniors who worked hard to reach this point today, and I know you all did, many of you overcame tremendous personal burdens, and all of you persevered through the most difficult time in a century. At this time, will all members of the class of 2022 please stand? Let's hear it for the class of 2022. All right, you may be seated. Now it's time to observe the rite of passage for which we are all here. Individual recognition of our graduating seniors in the class of 2022 before you head into a future of limitless possibilities. Lest I forget to mention what you are leaving behind, seniors. Graduates, your efforts help make Walt Whitman High School the number one ranked high school in the state of Maryland and one of the highest ranked high schools in our nation for 3 consecutive years. Thank you. Congratulations. You have set the highest standard of excellence through your resilience, courage, conduct, and achievements. Therefore, Dr. Joftis, I enthusiastically recommend to you the members of the class of 2022 as qualified candidates for the State of Maryland Diploma. Congratulations, graduates.
It is my pleasure and honor to introduce the Honorable Dr. Scott Joftis, Montgomery County Public Schools Board of Education member.
Whitman, it is my distinct honor to make this all official. It's even more of an honor getting to do so with Dr. Dodd. Thank you for those really, really nice remarks, and what an amazing school you run. I also appreciate Dr. Dodd mentioning my predecessor, Pat O'Neill, who passed away in September. I know she would be really honored and thrilled to be here with you all today. It's also my honor because, as Dr. Dodd mentioned, I am a father of a Whitman grad and a Whitman junior, so I'm very excited to experience this again next year, hopefully. She didn't hear me. Anyway, my distinct privilege to make this official. So by virtue of the authority vested in the Board of Education of Montgomery County under the laws of the state of Maryland, I do now award diplomas or certificates evidencing the satisfactory completion of prescribed courses of study to the students of Walt Whitman High School, who are recommended for graduation by the faculty of the school. In receiving this diploma or certificate, each of you is entitled to all of the privileges and honors accorded graduates of a high school accredited by the Maryland State Department of Education. Congratulations.
Carly Rothschild. Sophia Arul Pragasam. Sophie Hoffman. Jaden Vikram. Iman Ilias. Skylar Chasen. Amanda Sartori. Felix Leonhardt.
Sabina Abdow. Archie Achesa. Benjamin Adams. Grace Adkins. Gianna Agostini. Nicholas Alexander. Charles Allen. Frederick Alvarez. James Alzona. Jack Anderson. Pedro Andrade Fernandez Teixeira. Aro Andriami Robson. Maria Anino. Clara Antonetti. Yushi Appel. Sarah Arda. Jordan Arlen. Joseph Aaron. Kave Arsanjani. Yusuf Ashtorab. Sahana Ashley. William Asimakopoulos. Bertie Aubert. Kai Banda. Julia Baroldi. Alatis Barnes. Hugo Barnes. Deirdre Bartleman. Anna Bass. Anna Beatrice Bastos. Charles Beck. Griffin Beckley. Jamie Beers. Taylor Beers. Aaron Beckham. Axel Bell. Pascal Bell. Maria Berezina. Eli Berkovitz. Calvin Berlin. Krishna Bhatt. Vikram Bhatt. Sasha Blake. Samuel Bogdanovsky. Christopher Brown. John Brown. Bennett Browning. Thomas Buckley. Catherine Burton. Zoe Cantor. Jacina Carter. Carolyn Kitton. Helen Kitton. Ryan Cauldron. Madison Chambers. Zoe Charlton. Ashna Chawla. Henry Cheatham. Dylan Choi. Ryan Coe. Warner Cohen. Mary Conlin. Benjamin Conover. Ethan Corbin. Quentin Corpuel. Alexi Kostenko. Caitlin Cowan.
All right, Caitlin!
Mattis Crichton. Mark Kniff. Anna Curran. Alexander Daku. Vishnu Dandy. Ryan Darby. Izzy Davies. Marco Davila. Tara Davuti. Ryan Day. Felipe DeBole. Conrad DeCresson. Colin Del Toro. Delaney DiMartino. Lisi DeRosa. Nicholas Darmasiri. Matisse Diaz. Samuel Dodson. Sarah Donner. Joseph Dueck. Clara Dumont. Elizabeth Dupree. Catherine Dwyer. Charles Edmonds. Cameron Nazari. Matthew Eisner. Ruan Alakul. Haley Engelstad. Rafe Epstein. Adam Erdman. Caleb Achete. Maxwell Esther Gomi. Clint Faber. Arielle Fasna. Caroline Faust. Ollie Don Pizzelli. Talia Fechter. Preeti Fitta. Jenna Fields. Lindsay Feinberg. Ava Fishman. Renan Frank. Lily Freeman. Andre Friedman. Leonardo Galbati. Nicholas Gandolfo. Gael Garma Duflot. Elijah Gendelman. Santiago Giacomo Garcia. Emma Giles. Federica Gilly. Maya Goldman. Juliet Goldberg. Leah Goldstein. Grace Gontvik. Saskia Gonzalez. Madeline Graham.
Julia Gray. Madeline Griffin. Gianna Grissett. Campbell Gunther. Carrie Gunther. Sophia Gurovic. Nathan Hackle. Callie Hackett. Christopher Haddad. Elisheva Hombrecht. Lily Harburg. Katarina Hartzler. Eve Hastings. Sarah Hayes. Sawyer Hayes. Kendall Headley. Talia Heath. Scott Helberg. Jack Hairberger. Daisy Hester. Sean Higgins. Michael Himmelstein. Anna Hirsch. Abigail Horowitz. Gustavo Horta Gracindo. Grant Hoshe. Tyler Shea. Lily Shu. Mossab Hussein. Alexander Ibrahim. Hayden Eikenson. Demetrius Uano. Andrew Jacobson. Benjamin Jaffe. Romina Jalnus. Rita Gennaro. Declan Javers. Yi Jing. Callum Johnson. Charlotte Johnson. Ginevra Johnson. Tony Joseph. Francois Jove. Crizzle J. Justalera. Salamia Kutcher. Mario Kadnar. Sullivan Kadnar. Rocio Kaiser. Noah Camilla. Grant Cashton. Vonj Kataria. Jeremy Kaufman. Nora Kawamoto. Jacob Keller. Mason Kelly. Amir Khan. Cheyenne Khan. Irfan Khosravi. Grace Kim. Karina Kimberlin. Logan Kinsey-Meyer. Mira Kisslinger. Joshua Klubs. Sebastian Kobe. Anna Kobor. Angelina Kokanis-Bulaya. June Komoto. River Koss. Daniel Kotolansky. Anthony Kotiri. Grace Kowawu. Katerina Corlumbus. Edward Crawland. Rakesh Krishnan. Claire Lane. Josie Lane. Sarah LaPree. Ksenia Lehrin. Valentine Lawyers. Javier Laveaga. Joshua Lee. Amelia Levin. Jackson Levin. Leo Levine. Spencer Levy. David Lewis. Tyler Lewis. Grace Lee. Peter Lee. Lucy Lieber. Christina Lemansky. Emma Lynn. Claire Lipton. Maya Lipton. Jonathan Liu. Lily Liu. Alfonso Lopez Aguilera.
Yes.
Quentin Lugay.
Oh, you're not at the same time.
Oh, at the same time?
Alain Lutien. Elizabeth McNeese.
Sergio.
John Mayer.
Thank you.
Sarah Mackle. Taya Mangum. Alejo Marquieran. Hugh Markham. Robert Marshall. Daquan Martin. John Martin. Alexandra Masifletas. Uquin Mate Camas. Clara Maddock. Oliver Mattis-Bond. Guy Mayo. Austin Boyjana. John McGowan. Grace McClendon.
Way to go, Grace!
Emma McGarry. Jackson McGarry. Natalie Avey. Alex Arony. Alana Barsky. Sunny Basu. Sasha Bedratenko. Gabe Caraballo. Megan Chen. Rachel Chen. Jenny Cook. Grace Corbett. Julia Elliott. Cassidy Ayers. Emil Eisenhollen. Ava James. James Kirikoff. Maeve Kuipers. Topher Leonard.
Artie Mackey. Mia Martin. Ellie Mosman. Elephant Linden. Megan Pollock. Kiara Rosetto. Fiona Smith. Lauren Tan. Jenny Tang. Tess Vogel. Riley McNeil. Max Mizell. Ruth McConan. Zoe Mendel. Faraz Merchant. Daniel Mermelstein. Andrea Mikkel-Landa. Daniel Miller. Isabel Miller. Lucy Miller. Sam Mendel. Yazan Mokit. Madigan Mormon. Thomas Montoya Nova. Andrew Moon. Evelyn Morisak. Ryan Morris. Brennan Murley. Charles Nicholas Murray. Adam Nadifi. Aravind Venkatesh Nartajan. Catherine Navarette. Shai William Mirara Don Shai. Grace Nemiroff. Layla Nestor. Nina Nieno. Kaylee Nothman. Matisse Nurit. Celine O. Matthew Olevsky. Turcom Ono. Raquel Orla. Isabel Ostheimer. Audrey Ostoyich. Mohamed Usmain. Woo! Zachary Owen.
Way to go, Mohamed!
Neil Ozdemir. Nicholas Papadopoulos. Sophia Pappas. Camilo Pardo. Samuel Parks. Amelia Parardo Nezal. Noah Perlman. Matthew Pennybacker. Ella Perkins. Christopher Perney.
Guys, we can't stand at the phone.
Ashley Perrin. Nico Petit. Sophia Picone. Nicole Pines. Mariana Piontovaska. Uma Plens. Sophia Polyfinisic. Katie Posner. Isabel Prager. Aditya Prashant. Sarah Price. Parker Prophet. Mara Priyal. Gergo Pula. Marcy Pula. Diego Quijada. Caroline Quinn. Benjamin Rabley. Rebecca Ram. Aliana Rana. Eleanor Raiskovic. William Raiskovic. Anya Rathod. Tonpo Ratanochot. Azara Ravery. Alexis Raslog. Noah Ryskin. Hudson Reitkopf. Giles Remick. Saul De La Cruz Santos. Gilly Rice. Jeremy Rich. Martin Radau. John Robertson. Ryan Rabubi. Pablo Roy. Shelby Roman. Connor Root. Jonathan Rufer. Laura Rorowski. Hennessy Shabab. Anna Solowski. Arturo Salvalaggio. Miguel Samos Rivas. Amanda Sanders. Andrew Sanson.
Noah Sapara. Jake Schaefer. Jack Sheets. Charlie Schulman. Alex Schupak. Jacob Seiberg. Kayla Schaefer. Jade Shibani. Asra Shaikh. Kevin Shao. Kalem Sharma. Hadley Sharp. Evan Shavitz. Madeline Shavitz. Jack Shirley. Reese Shields. Kafu Shimomura. Netta Scherzad. Robert Shively. Clara Shopa. Benjamin Sykes. Devin Silver. Sophia Silvertooth. Peter Sylvia. Ian Sinkovich. Olivia Citrick. Katie Sclair. Ethan Smith. Evan Solnick. Julie Solonsky. Justin Sonnenreich. Ashley Sosa Rodriguez. Henry Sowles. Alexander Spencer. Sydney Spottiswood. Francisco Stadigan Vargas. Catherine Stearns. Michael Steger. Miku Steiner. Carla Steffen. Rachel Suisa. Tegan Sullivan. Quinn Sullivan. Ethan Sun. Otis Sun. Victoria Svenison. Chris Sylvester. Aliza Saeed. Delaney Taff. Sophie Tarlove. Samantha Tave. Nicholas Teo. Kaylee Tallman. Avantika Thea Garajan. Juliet Tillemion. Ezra Titsky. Joaquin Torres. Alan Tusi. Alan Sow. Ethan Tucker. Maya Tisbear. Allison Udler. Zoe Vanderbellen. Rena Van Leeuwen. Zahava Van Leeuwen. William Vanderwall. Mia Vernetti. Greer Vermillier. Ava Von Peckman. Maxwell Walker. Camille Vakovich Yvonne. Benjamin Wang. Cindy Wang. Xingqi Wang. Nansheng Wang. Matthew Wang. Younghan Wang. Michael Ward.
Way to go, Michael!
Abby Wasilu. Cole Wasilu. Paul Waxman. Weston Wildminster. Danielle Weinberg. Alvar Wetzel. Cole Wharton. Grady Wiley. Matthew Winter. Benjamin Wiseman. Joseph Wytok. Kip Wright. Elizabeth Wu. Olivia Shao. Christina Xiong. Sarah Yang. Zach Yacoub. Claire Young. Ava Zamani. Shaya Zamani. Alexandra Zaneski. Andrew Zarate. Grace Zhao. Vera Zhong. Betty Ju. Ethan Zamola. Annie Zamiri.
The Walt Whitman Alma Mater, performed by the Whitman Symphonic Orchestra and Combined Courses under the direction of Brendan Kelly and Michelle Kim.
Thank you.
seated. Graduates, please remain standing. Thank you so very much for joining us for this celebratory occasion. The turning of the tassel denotes and proclaims the transition from student to graduate. You have accomplished so much, and so I proudly stand here to usher in the official act that signifies that you, indeed, are Walt Whitman alumni. Now, class of 2022, place your right hand on your tassel and join me as we turn them from right to left. Congratulations, graduates.